By the way, would like to wish happy birthday to his niece, Haley. She just turned 3 a few days ago, so happy birthday to Haley. Haley Kroll, as Dyke takes a fastball strike. So Uncle Joey says happy birthday. Maybe he can hit a home run for you. Ball one. And the bunt is shown, pushed in front of the plate. Steinlein has a play to the first base. They get out there. Now the throw to home is not in time as Renaud waited long enough and scores on the safety squeeze. They get the out at first base. There is one down.
And it is
1-0. Hitter's position, the pitch, ground ball through the middle into center field, past Steinlein. Coming around third is Wagner. Here's the throw from Dyke. It's going to be offline. And now Schultz throwing through to second base, and Kratky will be out there, but the run scores. It's an RBI single for Ruben Kratky. 2-1 pitch to him. Line drive, left center field. Dyke's got a long run. He's not going to get it. Base hit. Another run will score. That's Ribbons. Moving all the way to third is Zeller. And Ng is in at second base standing up. So Dyke was playing Ng to pull, and he just served one right into that left center field gap. And it is an RBI double. The 0-2 pitch to Herring. Slow curve, strike three called, and the inning is over. So Steinlein recovers. That's his first strikeout. The inning is over. Three runs come home on Ng not going. Swung on, grounded on a big hop to Peterson. He's going to go to second for one. Throw to first. Double play. 5-4-3, and that is what the Disciples needed. Two down. Wolf to Wolf appears to have everything going. This ball is bunted, and it's going to be fielded on a few hops by Hagen Retz, whose throw to first is high and goes all the way to the backstop. Rufio's going to go to second base, and he is in there sliding. That's a throwing error on Hagen Retz. It might have been a base hit anyway, but Schultz is now at second base, and that's all that really matters. Steinlein, the pitch. Hit sharply up the middle into center field. That's going to get through for a base hit. Rufio is being held at third base by Sandorsius. Ng throws all the way to the plate, and taking second base on Ng's throw is Lucas Steinlein. So that'll be a base hit to center field. Conservative base running by the Disciples, and wisely so. There's no reason to have a run get thrown out at home plate. Schultz makes it to third on the single. Steinlein with a single takes second on the throw. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Line drive, base hit to right center field. Schultz is going to score. Steinlein is coming home. The ball is bobbled in center field by Ng. Selsemeyer trying for two. The throw is not in time. It is a two-run single for David Selsemeyer, and he takes second base on the error by Gavin Ng in center field. And there's the tying run. It is 3-2, Stuttgart. There's the 0-1 to Bossel. Grounded third base and past Hagen Retz down the line. That is a base hit. Selsemeyer coming to the plate. The game is tied. Bossel stops at first base with an RBI single, and we are tied at 3. From set and deals. Swing and a miss, he struck him out. Down go the Reds, 1-2-3. That is Steinlein's third K of the afternoon. Ribbons off third, and a throw to third. And the ball gets away from Peterson, and there's a gift run as Ribbons will score. So they tried the pickoff play and it did not work. Towards right center, there's a huge gap in left center. Curveball tapped weakly to the right side. It gets past Steinlein, charging Auerhammer on the run. Throw to first, inning over. He got the job done. So Lucas Steinlein, all in all, dodges more damage, but a run comes home. No strikes to him. Pitch hit sharply on the ground, but Peterson is right there. The throw to first is low, and Stefan scooped it. Good scoop by Mitch Stefan. That saved a run. The inning is over. So no run. First, this one slapped to the right side towards the hole, and it's into right field for a base hit. So Treasel with a seeing eye ground ball that squirts through the infield just past the glove of Verdi. And Kevin is aboard and deals. There's another bouncing ball. This one is going to be knocked over by Gonzalez. He can't make the play, and he shovels it away from the base. Treasel coming to the plate. Here's the throw. Treasel slides. He is out at the plate as the ball was recovered by DeWolf and threw it to Jonathan Wagner. Treasel slid under the tag or attempted to slide under the tag, but the call was made right away, and he is out trying to score the tying run. Here's the pitch. There's a swing and a drive to deep left field. Did he get high enough? He did. It's gone. Two-run home run for Joe Dyke, and the Hart Disciples lead this game 5-4. And that one's for you, Haley. Home run number 6 for Joey. And he has put a smile and a standing ovation by the fans here in Haar. 5-4 on a 2-out 8th inning blast by Joe Dyke. The only question was whether it was going to be high enough. And it was, and it carried over the fence. Haar with a 5-4 lead in the bottom of the 8th inning. The wind and the pitch. Swing and a miss on a ball in the dirt. Blocked by Schultz. He picks it up, throw to first. 1 out in the 9th. Ball game. 3-2 with Ng off second base. The pitch to Herring. Swing and a miss. He struck him out on a slow breaking ball. A huge pitch by Kevin Treasel. And there are two down. However, 2 outs in the 9th inning. The pitch to Renault. Swinging a ground ball to Peterson. He's going to take it to the bag. He tags out Ng on the way by. Ball game over. And the Haar Disciples on the 2-out 8th inning home run by Joey Dyke win this game by a score of 5-4. Thomas DeWolf, the losing pitcher in a super effort. Kevin Treasel gets the win in relief of Lucas Steinlein, who pitched 7 strong innings. The player of the game, Joey Dyke. And Joey wanted me to wish happy birthday to his niece, Haley. And happy birthday, Haley, the best birthday present that Joey could have sent you, a game-winning home run in the 8th inning.